right, how you doing? Billy Ashbaugh here, drummerconnection.com. Welcome back again. And today we're going to do opening hi-hat grooves part two. We're going to kind of pick up where part one left off. We're going to go to the ride here in a second and get the left hand busy. But first, there's a few things I want to cover on the hi-hat still. Now, the first lesson, we concentrated mainly on opening the left foot with the hi-hat on its own, sort of getting used to just getting it in the mix. Now, I want to put the bass drum underneath it as we open it. So to get started here, I want to give you an example of what's going to happen when you open on the and of beat four. Now, what's going to happen as the right foot goes down for the and of four, left foot comes up. Now, the left foot has to go back down just as the right foot hits the downbeat of the following measure. Sounds like this. Now, let's mess with the and of one. So what's going to happen here is on that second bass drum hit, you're going to hit the downbeat of one, then the and of one. For the and of one, bring the left foot up and then close it down just as the snare hits on beat two. Here's a new one for you. Let's try opening the hi-hat with a snare hit. Let's try beat two. So what's going to happen as you hit the snare with the left hand, the left foot comes up and is going to close down on the end of two. Okay, now we're going to move over to the ride. Straight eighth notes with the right hand on the ride. So now our left hand is going to be responsible for getting up from the hi-hat and back to the snare, but we're still going to keep every two and four nice and solid on the snare. Let's start with the and of two. So now, after we hit two, we have to go up to the and of two, close it down on the downbeat of three, and then come back on beat four with the snare. Okay, staying on the ride with the right hand. Now let's do something that happens right before a backbeat. Let's open on the and of three. So we're just going to hang out for two, but we're going to jump up, open the hi-hat for the and of three, and then close it, and then come back down with the left hand and hit four on the snare. Now let's look at opening with the left hand right on beat three. So now we're going to do what we sort of introduced on the hi-hat at the beginning of this lesson. We now have the left foot coming up as the right foot's hitting at the same time the left hand's coming over and hitting it on the downbeat, closing on the end of three and then hitting four with the left hand on the snare. Okay, this one is going to open on the and of four. Again, with the bass drum underneath this time, so you're going to hit beat four, come up for the and of four. While you hit the bass drum on the and of four, tighten the left foot down as you hit the beginning of the next measure on one with the bass drum. And one more possibility for today, like there isn't enough, we're going to open on the and of one, okay? Hitting the downbeat again, playing two eighth notes with the bass drum. The second, the and of one that we hit with the bass drum, we're going to reach up, hit the snare on the and, close the left foot as we come down with the left hand to hit the snare for beat two. Okay, hope you enjoyed that, opening hi-hat grooves part two. Covering a lot of ground here. We got the bass drum underneath the hi-hat, not underneath the hi-hat, before the snare, after the snare, left hand, right hand, involving the ride. So just relax with this stuff. again, I covered a lot of ground, so just be patient. And remember to go at your own pace with this stuff, but it's really worth investigating because it adds a lot of colors and some very cool dimensions to your playing. So enjoy this stuff and check back. Thanks.